Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good morning, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your morning flash update for this whopper of an October. Yeah, we're going to look back at this. It's a big one. And this is Halloween, October 31st, 2018, and we're about 9:15 a.m. Central Daylight Time. So no, it's no joke. It's no trick-or-treat. We are starting off with a good move in the stock indices. Now, for those of you that watch my end-of-the-day videos, you know that I believe that momentum leads price. And you lost the downside momentum on the close yesterday, and you're surging today in terms of that. Will it hold? In other words, will the market unwind that downside momentum that it's lost? That's the big question right now. In foreign currency trade, not an awful lot going one way or the other, but if you look at the Japanese yen right here, you can see this market has fallen, and it went to its lower Bollinger band. So when the fear hit the markets in October, you went up to the upper band, now you're at the lower band, market walking away from that. We're looking at lower energy prices almost across the board with the exception of nat gas. Harvest pressure continues on all the grains as you'd expect. The farmers are rushing at it now. There was about 7 inches of snow in the Rockies. Cold weather's coming. We're in November. They've got to finish up what they're doing. And notice bonds and notes back to normal, higher rates coming onto the scene there. These are the things where you're getting away from this October into a more normal trade. The problem is next week we have the elections. Does the president lose the House? Does the president hold on to the Senate? If he holds on to both, probably a euphoric rally in the stock market. If he loses the House, probably balance there because he still has veto power in the Senate. He loses both the House and the Senate, a lot gets unraveled. You'll hear talk of impeachment against the president, so on and so forth. So there's an awful lot at stake. Enjoy what you have right now because this all starts again right after that, and there's many different outcomes we have to look at. Now for today, the Conference Board U.S. Online Help Wanted Index, 267,300. The PMI came in at 58.4. They expected 60. Prior month was 60.4. The Employment Index came in at the cost index up 0.8. They expected that. The cost index year over year up 2.8%, pretty much in line with things. ADP payroll up 227. They expected 180. So that is real strong. Then China's official PMI index for October fell to 50.2. Let me tell you what's important about that. Under 50 means contraction. That's the dividing point. So we are looking at something here that they could be getting into trouble on. Germany's top business group, that shouldn't have happened, lobby group, put out a paper today that said that what Germany is looking at now is that they are not trusting that they should be going for their supplies to China. Same problem the U.S. is having. The problem centers around the fact thievery, and that is a big, big problem of intellectual property. CPI prices in France rose a tenth on the month, and that was below the expectation. They were looking actually a little better than that. Canada's raw material price index fell 0.9 for the month. Eurozone jobless rate at 8.1%. And Eurostat today pegged October CPI for the Eurozone at 2.2, in line with the forecast. China's ag ministry said they removed a different area. I don't know why that keeps happening to us. They removed a different area here for the swine flu. And Australia's third quarter CPI up 0.4 on the quarter, one-tenth less than the market thought. You know, everything's moving on me here. I don't know what happened. We'll go through that later. I want to remind you, one of the things that I use in the trading analysis that I do is this Moore Research Center. Now, let me tell you what it is. I am looking for seasonal trades. Example, there's a seasonal trade right now in the Dow Jones to the upside. coming in right on this break and the market looking for it to rally further. What are the probabilities? What's the entry date? What's the exit date? How much does the market on average lose or win? So you get to get this in these reports, and you can go commodity, commodity. You want to learn what gold does? Go to the gold section. It'll break it down for you as to where you're at. Charts. Let's assume you want to look at a chart, and what they do is pretty neat. They create interactive charts that go back 30 years of data, 15 and 5. You can eliminate either ones you want. You can add to the chart bull or bear years and filter it further. And yes, you can go day by day to see what you're looking at. For those of you that get my metal reports, this is one of the services that I use in it, and I've been with them decades. I mean, they know me forever. And it is a neat service. Obviously, and the word is obviously, one of the caveats with services like this is past performance is not a guarantor of future performance. But it is history. It does tell you what the market did, and they take it a step further. If they can't get reliabilities of over 80%, they drop that trade and add new ones as time goes on. To get your 2-week trial free, give my staff a call, go to our website, sign up for it, or right here, we'll get you your username and password, and away you go. I'm Ira Epstein. Thanks for watching. Happy Halloween, and I'll see you this afternoon.